This is Kdenlive, KDE's nonlinear video editor, the only full-feature editor that you can download for free and run on any system, whether it's Windows, Mac, or even Linux. With Kdenlive, you can execute all of the edits you'd expect from the supposed pros, such as Apple's Final Cut Pro and Adobe's Premiere Pro. To get started, head on over to kdenlive.org. When you get there, select Download, and you'll be taken to the current stable version. Kdenlive is released quarter yearly, so there are 4 major updates every year. As I'm making this video, the current build is version 23.08.4. Your version may be a couple of releases above mine, which is even better. I'm going to show you how to download, install, and use Kdenlive on Linux. For Windows users, check out this video that I made especially for you. The link is in the description. Here on my Linux computer, I have Ubuntu LTS installed, but I literally could be using a fax machine and I'd still be able to run Kdenlive, which is far more forgiving than the supposed pros. When downloading Kdenlive for Linux, you are presented with three options. If you select the Ubuntu PPA, you'll find that within the download page, they use language such as unsupported and untrusted, so you're better off staying away from it. That leaves you with the app image and the Flatpak. I'll show you how to use both. So I'll download this, select here, and also download that. After both downloads are finished, to use the Flatpak, you have to install it onto your computer. Within the folder where you have the Flatpak saved, right-click on the blank space, then select Open in Terminal. Inside of the terminal, type in the following commands: sudo apt update, followed by sudo apt upgrade, to ensure that all of the software on your computer is up to date. You may need to wait a few minutes for it to finish. Before you can install the Kdenlive package, you have to install a package manager. Type in the following command: sudo apt install flatpak. Wait for it to finish, and you can now install Kdenlive. To do so, you have to type in the command flatpak install org.kde.kdenlive.flatpakrev. You do not need to manually spell all of that out. You can just type org, then press the tab button, and that should autocomplete the rest of it. Press enter, type Y, press enter, and wait for it to finish. And once it's done, you can find the launcher under the applications menu. You can now run Kdenlive, and this is what it looks like. If it seems kind of chaotic and you need a tutorial on the user interface, I've already made one for you. The link is in the description. To use the app image instead, you have to right-click on it, select Properties, go to Permissions, and make sure that Allow Executing File as Program is checked. The point of using the app image is that you can copy it onto a removable drive such as a USB stick, and you can use Kdenlive on a different computer without needing to install it. But you will need to first copy the app image onto that other computer before running it. You cannot run the app image from the removable drive. You can open the app image by double-clicking on it. Wait for it to launch, and you are now running Kdenlive. And if it's a bit overwhelming for you at first, you can also watch this video focusing on the user interface to help you get started. I'll see you over there.